quick concepts here, brief lessons. So let's talk about the relationship between normal time, half time, and double time. This is a trick where you can avoid accelerating, in other words, passing through every speed from that is between one speed and another. Like if you're in a car and you're going down the on-ramp onto the highway, you can't just get from 0 to 60. You got to pass through 35 and 45, and then you're finally there. Or slamming on the brakes, you got to pass from however fast you're traveling to 0 through all the speeds in between. And that's something we want to generally avoid as drummers. But sometimes the song wants to feel a little quicker or wants to feel a little slower. And a good way to orchestrate that without having to accelerate or decelerate is to use related times. In other words, to take the balance of our anatomy of a beat, to take it goes back and forth from bass to snare, and just sort of space it differently. So if our normal beat is going, the basic skeleton is going 1 on the bass, 2 on the snare, 3 on the bass, 4 on the snare, boom, dot, boom, dot. If we move, if we space that out, where we have still 1 on the bass and 3 on the snare, then it's going to have the effect of sounding like it is half as fast. In other words, half time. And it'll sound like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Similarly, if we want it to sound twice as fast, with it, again, not actually accelerating to get there, what we'll do is we'll make the bass drum move from being just on 1 and 3 to being on all 4 beats, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the snare will fill a different gap. It'll rock back and forth on the ands of each of those. So we'll be going like 1, 2, 3, 4, how one of the things that and so I guess something to pay attention to as you're learning to do that without incident is to really remember, because drumming is it's a really physical instrument, but it's also a really mental instrument, and it's also really oral. In other words, A-U-R. It's something where you really need to use your ears. And you got to balance those things. You may find as you're teaching yourself to do that, that your instinct is that the whole mechanism of your locomotion wants to speed up anyway, wants to accelerate or wants to slow down, wants to decelerate. Really focus on the fact that your right hand on the hi-hat does not change. So let me show you again and really look at my right hand. 1, 2, 3. You can even skip from halftime to double time, and in other words, quadruple the apparent speed. So that's just something to have in your back pocket. Now, it should be noted that that can sound really cool in a song, but it also can be really disorienting to the other players if they don't know it's coming. You should fool around with it. You should experiment with it when you're playing along with like pre-recorded music, or when you're in a jam session, you know, just a private, non-performative situation where everyone's kind of experimenting anyway. That's a good time to sometimes just throw it in there and see what happens. So that's just something to be aware of, something to have in your back pocket, and something to know how to do is how to move. move from whatever the regular feel is to halftime or double time. All right, so hopefully that was helpful, and until next time.